Welcome back, Fallbrook.
Good morning, Fallbrook. Today is Tuesday, August 16th. My name is Sebastian, and these are your morning announcements. Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Here's some news for you.
Good morning. FFA had a great 2022 San Diego County Fair, and we'd like to give out some congratulations. We're going to spend a few days on this because there were so many great highlights coming from that show. In the FFA Breeding Livestock Show for Dairy Goats, Senior Taylor Michalk won two awards, the Showmanship Champion Award, as well as the Reserve Grand Champion. In the FFA Market Livestock Show for Market Goats, recent graduate Cassidy Belanger took second place, as well as being named the Reserve Champion. And Madison Hayes won the Novice Market Goat Showmanship Championship. Congratulations. And you know what? We're going to be back tomorrow with more awards from the county fair. Congratulations, FFA. Students, remember, the cafeteria has done away with its keypad system. Instead, we're going to be using the barcode on your student ID. This barcode can also be pulled up on your phone through the 5-Star student app, which you learned about yesterday. Also yesterday, you saw what was in store for you at lunch and breakfast at all our various lunch stations. We have a lot of stations. But most of those stations will stay the same, so I'm not going to repeat those graphics again. If you want to go back and look at the smaller stations, refer back to Monday's broadcast. But guess what? The main cafeteria does a daily revamp of their menu for lunch and breakfast. So here's a look at what's happening today at lunch and tomorrow at breakfast.
Warriors, Mrs. Hahn here from the Counseling Department. Welcome back to school. The Counseling Department wants to give some helpful information regarding schedules and requests as we get the ball rolling on this school year. Schedule change requests can be done in the first 2 weeks of school. Not all requests can be guaranteed as classes fill up quickly and cannot guarantee your teachers and periods would stay the same if we are able to make that request. Level downs can be done in the first 2 weeks of school for AP and IB classes, while honors have up to 6 weeks. Both of those forms that you need can be found in the counseling office. We do not allow teacher changes and period changes. I am so sorry. Now, if there's a certain situation, obviously talk to your counselor. But for the most part, those will be an automatic denial. Qualified seniors can request to be TAs for the counseling office or a teacher. You just have to check in with your counselor to make sure you qualify and then be able to find a teacher you would like to TA for. Lastly, thank you for your patience as we try to get through the requests. Hope you have a great day.
Students, one key to a successful high school experience is to get involved with the community. And a great way to do that is through all of our clubs and organizations. On Wednesday, August 31st, ASB is going to be hosting a club rush in the bowl. So come on out August 31st to meet all the different clubs and the officers to figure out where you want to invest your time. Thanks. And while we're thinking about investment, attention all students, you are all invited to be a part of the Superintendent's Student Advisory Committee. The committee is an opportunity for your voice to be heard and for you to provide valuable input on your education. The meetings are once a month on the fourth Tuesday of every month, and there won't be any meetings in November and December because of our holiday schedule. The meetings will take place in room 15 at 3:30, and food will be provided at each meeting. Do consider getting involved. Our first meeting is going to be Tuesday, August 30th.
Let's look at some college and career news.
Our partners at the Sheet Metal Apprenticeship Program would like to invite you to attend a free career fair September 7th from 3 to 5 p.m. For those unfamiliar with the term sheet metal, This refers to any metal that can be formed into flat pieces of varying thickness. Sheet metal workers cut, roll, bend, and shape these pieces to make a wide variety of objects, such as ductwork, airplane wings, car bodies, refrigeration units, medical tables, and that's just a few of the amazing things sheet metal workers create. You need to complete a four-year apprenticeship with 1,000 hours of hands-on training to be a sheet metal worker, but most of those hours are paid gig, and the average hourly rate for a sheet metal worker is $25 an hour. Sheet metal workers average $53,000 a year. For more information, go to this career fair. It's free and no registration is required.
And now, it's time for sports.
Any student interested in trying out for any sports must be cleared through the athletics department, okay? Before they even try out. So if you're new to this, here are the three things that must be done. Number one, a parent or guardian will need to create an online clearance account. Number two, a current sports physical must be uploaded into the online clearance system. And number three, a copy of the student's health insurance card must also be uploaded into the online clearance system. So it's just that easy. Register in the system, upload your physical, upload your insurance card. Remember, no clearance. You can't even step on the field to try out. But we do want you, especially you freshmen, new to our school, to try out and get involved. Thanks.
That's all of the news for now. Have a wonderful Tuesday. Every day just gets a little shorter.